मेडिकल टर्मिनेशन ऑफ प्रेगनेंसी अमेंडमेंट बिल 2020। द यूनियन कैबिनेट हैज़ अप्रूव द मेडिकल टर्मिनेशन ऑफ प्रेगनेंसी MTP अमेंडमेंट बिल 2020 टू अमेंड द मेडिकल टर्मिनेशन ऑफ प्रेगनेंसी एक्ट 1971। वॉट वॉज द नीड ऑफ द न्यू बिल ऑन अबॉर्शन? सेक्शन 3 ऑफ द मेडिकल टर्मिनेशन ऑफ प्रेगनेंसी एक्ट 1997 कैप्ड द अबॉर्शन लिमिट एट 20 वीक्स। अंडर द सेक्शन 5 ए वुमेन कुड अंडरगो अबॉर्शन बियॉन्ड द 20 वीक्स ओनली इफ हर लाइफ वॉज एंडेंजर्ड बाय द प्रेगनेंसी, बट देर रिमेन्ड नो प्रोविजन फॉर फीटस दैट वर डायग्नाइज्ड विद सीवियर लाइफ थ्रेटनिंग डिफेक्ट्स। मोस्ट बर्थ डिफेक्ट्स आर डायग्नाइज्ड बिटवीन 16 to 18 वीक्स ऑफ प्रेगनेंसी, बट सम अनोमलीज ऑफ ब्रेन एंड स्पाइन कैन बी डिटेक्टेड ओनली आफ्टर द 20 वीक्स। द MTP एक्ट 1971 वॉज रिप्लीट विद अनक्लियर लैंग्वेज विच रिजल्टेड इन डॉक्टर्स रेफ्यूजिंग टू परफॉर्म अबॉर्शंस इवन विद द स्टिपुलेटेड 20 वीक जेस्टेशन लिमिट फियरिंग क्रिमिनल चार्जेस। Women had to seek the approval of the judiciary, which is by most accounts did not always come in time. As a result, notes a 2015 study in the India Journal of Medical Ethics, 10 to 13% of maternal deaths in India are due to unsafe abortions. Given the delays in the judicial system, the 20-week mark often passed, leaving many, including the rape survivors, with unwanted pregnancies. Features of the new bill. The bill proposes to permit the termination of the pregnancy up to 24 weeks from the existing 20 weeks. It aims to expand access of women to safe and legal abortion services on therapeutic, eugenic, humanitarian or social grounds. Amendments proposed in the bill are requirements for the amendments proposed in the bill are the requirements for the opinion of one doctor for termination of pregnancy up to 20 weeks of gestation, and introducing the requirement of opinion of the two doctors for termination of pregnancy of 20 to 24 weeks of gestation. The bill also proposed enhancing the upper gestation limit from 20 to 24 weeks for special categories of women, which will be defined in the amendments to the MTP rules and would include vulnerable women, including the survivors of rape, victims of incest, and other vulnerable women like differently abled women, minors, etc. Upper gestation limit will not apply in cases of substantial fetal abnormalities diagnosed by the medical board. The composition functions and other details of the medical board is to be prescribed subsequently in the rules under the act. The name and other particulars of women whose pregnancy has been terminated shall not be revealed except to a person authorized in any law for the time being in force. Significance: the extension of the limit would ease the process women, allowing the mainstream system itself to take care of them, delivering quality medical attention. It has a provision to protect the privacy of a person seeking abortion. The proposed increase in gestational age will ensure dignity, autonomy, confidentiality and justice for the women who needed to terminate a pregnancy. The extension will help victims of rape, girls with disabilities, as well as minors who may not realize they are pregnant until later. Issue area: first, it does not allow abortion on request at any point after the pregnancy. Second, it does not take a step towards removing the prejudice against the unmarried woman by amending the relevant provision. Third, it enhances the gestational limit from the legal abortion from 20 to 24 weeks only for a specific categories of women, such as survivors of rape, victims of incest and minors. This means that a woman who does not fall into these categories would not be able to seek an abortion beyond the 20 weeks, even if she suffers from a grave physical or mental injury due to the pregnancy. Finally, MTP will be extended till the 24 weeks only for a certain category of women. There is also a provision that says pregnancies with fetal abnormalities can be terminated only after being approved from the medical boards. Medical boards often delay medical interventions required and often do not have the right kind of specialists. In conclusion, the government needs to ensure that all the norms and standardized protocols in the clinical practice to facilitate abortions are allowed in healthcare institutions across the country. Government should also learn from the experiences of the 1971 Act. The new piece of legislation should be worded in a manner that removes the frequent appeals to the judiciary.